Mr. President, Mr. Commissioner, tragically, the incidents of bloodshed in Sri Lanka continue to occur, and responsibility lies with both government and Tamil forces. Evidence from the SLMM shows that A, the government forces have killed 17 aid workers, B, the LTTE have bombed a bus, killing 64 civilians, and C, the Sri Lankan Air Force has bombed a campsite in the north, killing 51 young people. Mr. President, whilst in the short term there is an urgent need for an independent commission to investigate recent disappearances, abductions and extrajudicial executions, in the long term we must repeat the call made by this House in the last resolution for a wide-ranging human rights agreement between the parties involved in this civil war and its facilitation by an effective independent international monitoring mission. The lessons learned from the weaknesses of the SLMM demonstrate that for human rights to be a fundamental building block of a just and enduring resolution of the conflict, this body must have real enforcement mechanisms and unhindered access to both government and LTTE-controlled areas. Let us hope that a political solution that would be acceptable to Sri Lanka's minority communities will soon be found, and lasting peace and prosperity will replace violence and poverty.